Jayo Sri Vrindavan, Sri Vrindavan, Sri Vrindavan, Jayo Sri Vrindavan. Ami Jamuna Puline Kadamba Kanane Kiheri no Saki Aja. Ami Jamuna Puline Kadamba Kanane Kiheri no Saki Aja. Ama Shama Bamsi Dari Mani Mansha Pari Lila Kori Rasa Raja. Ama Shama Bamsi Dari Mani Mansha Pari Lila Kori Rasa Raja. Tara asta talo pari, Sri Radha jihari, asta saki pari jana. Tara asta talo pari, Sri Radha Sri Hari, asta saki pari jana. Asta tara asta talo pari. Sri Radha, Sri Hari, Asta Saki Pari Jana. Hara asta talo pari, Sri Radha Sri Hari, asta saki pari jana. Tara Sukita Nartane, Sabe Saki Gane, Tusi Che Jugaladane. Thara Sugita Narthane Sava Saki Gane Tusi Cheju Kaladane. Thakam Krishna Lila Hari Prakriti Sundari Vistari Che Sobevana. Krishna Thakam Krishna Lila Hari Prakriti Sundari Vistari Che Sobevanae. Ami kari na jaibo, vane pravishibo, o lila rase rathare. Ami kari na jaibo, vane pravishibo, O lila rase rathare. Ami tyaja kula laj baja prajaraj vinora moni minate kore. Amityati kula laj baja prajaraj vinoda minate kore. Ami jamuna puline khadam bakkanane kiheri nu sakhiya ja. Ami jamuna puline Kadam bakanane kiheri no sakia ja. Ami jamuna puline kadam bakanane. Ama shama bamsidari mani mansha pari. Lila kore rasa raja. Ama shama bamsi dari mani mansha pari. Lila kore rasa raja. Ami jamuna puline. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, everybody. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, everybody. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare.
Causeless mercy of Sri Guru Gauranga and the Vaishnavas, we are taking shelter of the shade of Bhandirvan. I sense that everyone is very deeply longing to hear Her Grace Jagatarini Devi to speak. That was not very good, Haribo. If you really want to open your hearts to be receptive to her ambrosial flow of nectar, you have to loudly chant Haribo.
Ma Om Vishnu Padaya, Krishna Prastaya Bhutale, Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namane. Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharani Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Praskatya Desitarani. So, it is by Maharaja's kind arrangement that we all have the opportunity to sit under this extraordinarily beautiful and completely transcendental tree. This banyan tree marks the place where Sri Sri Radha and Krishna were married. Of course, we know that Radha and Krishna are not married in a sense like the queens of Dwarka are married to Krishna, but in a very sweet way, a marriage ceremony took place here. As I have heard this story, Nanda Maharaj was sometimes nearby with the cows, taking care of the cows, and Krishna, as a small baby boy, practically just walking, toddling, was with his father. And as they were walking here and there, he was following behind the cows. In the sky, a great storm appeared to be coming. And Nanda Maharaj became quite worried that what would happen to his baby son if a great storm took place. And so just as he was thinking where to find somebody to take his son back to the camp where the other cowherd men and women and the other children were, he was looking this way and that way, and he saw one very, very small, very sweet, petite lali was walking nearby. And he recognized that this was the daughter of Vrishabhanu Maharaj. And he called her, "Lali, Lali, come." And he took Krishna's hand and he put their hands together and he said, "You take him, you walk together and go back to the camp." So they walked some short distance until they came to this tree. And inconceivably, Krishna, although appearing one moment as a small baby, manifests his form as the Jugal Kishore, Radha and Krishna. And all of the Sakis appeared, as if from nowhere. Lalita Sakhi, Vishakha Devi, Induleka, Rangadevi, Sudevi, Champakalata, everyone appeared. And then Lord Brahma, who was flying overhead, he was returning from Pushkar. He saw below this congregation and he alighted here from his swan carrier. And he was the one that performed this beautiful beautiful wedding ceremony, a play ceremony for Radha and Krishna, so that they are considered to be eternally married. So Lord Brahma came and the Sakhis, they tied together the cloth of Radha and Krishna and they sat under this beautiful tree and they sang so many sweet songs to them. And then Lord Brahma, he left and all the cowherd girls, they again began to play in a very affectionate way with Srimati Radharani and Krishna. So there are many other pastimes that took place here. The first time that I came to this place was in 1987, I think, with the first Rajamandal Prikrama. We had completed the Prikrama on the other side of the Jamuna, on Krishna's side of the Jamuna, and we were at Nandagat when somebody was giving the information that there are some forests that we will miss out on visiting on our set routine schedule that had been made. So we quickly and spontaneously crossed the Jamuna River all together late in the afternoon and came to Bhandirvan. Then we walked from Bhandirvan here to Bhandirvan. And it was getting just on sunset by the time we were ready to arrive here. And we walked around and looked at the tree and we heard some of the pastimes at that time of this place. And then Lokanath Maharaj called us very, very quickly to again cross the Jamuna. We were able to cross the Jamuna. It must have been very low because we could walk across the Jamuna without getting our clothes very wet. And we got to the other side of the Jamuna and then we had great difficulty, it seemed, in finding our way to our camp for that night, which was in a place called Say. But it was a great adventure with many profound realizations to be shared. As we walked in the dark, lost in the dark of Braj, until we finally arrived at our destination. Then I came back here many, many times because soon after that I decided it would be very nice to collect the dust of Braj from different places and put it into little containers that I found in Delhi, and the water in little vials, and decorate a box and make little boxes of Braj dust. So in this way some devotees very kindly, together we made boxes of memories of Vrindavan, just boxes with Vrindavan, local Vrindavan places. Then Nandagram, then Varshana, then we did other places as well, Kamyavan, Uchagram. And eventually we got very ambitious and decided we should make a box with dust and water from all the 12 forests of Vrindavan. So we came here many times to Bhandirvan to collect some dust and also to collect profusely the peacock feathers that you find. And we would wander around here picking up peacock feathers to take back to place in the boxes that we were sending to different devotees. Different devotees were taking them to share them all over the world with their friends. So just for myself, I began to realize that just by wandering in Vrindavan, unconscious of the transcendental pastimes or the extraordinary nature of the Dham, but just wandering in the dust, picking up the peacock feathers, taking a bottle of water from one kund and another, Gradually, Vrindavan started to appear to be very much like home. And then all the pastimes of Radha and Krishna, they seemed more like the activities of somebody who you know very well, rather than some stories from a Prikram book. So this place is especially familiar and it's especially sweet because here, I'm sure Maharaj will tell you so many of the other wonderful pastimes that took place in this area, but it is a very natural and comfortable place in Vrindavan to visit and to be. This banyan tree is especially famous because of being the tree that Radha and Krishna were married under, but also it is very, very old. You can see it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 trunks. It also had a couple more, I think, about 10 years ago. So I will stop here and look forward very much to hearing Maharaj tell us in detail and in color some of the wonderful pastimes that took place here. Thank you very much. Hari Bol.
Some distance from here, Krishna, Balaram, and the cowherd boys were herding their calves. While herding their calves, they would play so many wonderful games. In fact, Krishna, who is Gopal, Govinda, who protects and gives pleasures to the cows and calves, in one sense, he used his occupation as a cowherd boy as a wonderful facility to play all day with the gopas and to meet gopis also. How many games the gopas would play together? And all the games ultimately were just to give pleasure to Krishna. And Krishna was playing the games just to give pleasure to all of his friends. In Vrindavan, everything is a reciprocation of pure ecstatic love. In this world, when we play games, sometimes it's competitive, yes? Or self-centered, I want to win. If I win, then people will know I'm very good. Or we play just because we're so agitated and bored, we just want something to do, yes? Or children play because they have all this youthful, passionate little energy and they just want to just beat each other. Boys beat each other. Girls, they do all nice little things. As far as what I see, I don't know what else. But they play. But in Vrindavan, which is the place that is the origin of all play, it is an expression of pure, unalloyed, ecstatic love. The gopas play so many games with Krishna just to give pleasure to Krishna and Balaram, just to make them happy. And actually, they're having fun because they know that Krishna is happy when they have fun. Yes? Even they're having fun as an offering of love to Krishna and Balaram. And Krishna and Balaram reciprocate. They want to exchange and see their devotees happy. So yes, in the spiritual world, the play of Krishna and the gopas are exchanges of infinitely pure, ecstatic devotion. Loving exchanges, the nectar that cannot be found anywhere in material existence, except in the hearts of those who always remember Krishna and never forget Krishna. What to speak of the wonderful pastimes of Nanda, Yashoda and Krishna, or the Braj Gopis? It is the land of prema. So they played so many games. Sometimes they would play their flutes, dance. Sometimes they would take amalaki or or bale fruits and throw them very high in the sky. And then they take another fruit and try to hit that fruit. That was the game. It was a contest. Who can do? One boy would throw a fruit in the sky and then the other boy had to take another fruit and hit that fruit. And if he missed, everyone would laugh at him.
And if he would hit the fruit, everyone would cheer and cheer and raise their arms and jump, celebrate. Sometimes they would play football with amalaki or bale fruits. But not the same type of football that you play. Sometimes they would cover themselves, two or three or sometimes even four coward boys would cover themselves with big, big, big blankets and pretend to be bulls or cows. And then some other boys would do that, and then the bulls would fight one another. Team sport, very nice. Sometimes they would imitate animals, the cooing of the peacocks, the chirping of the birds, the croaking of the frogs. They would imitate the animals in so many ways. In this way, they spent all their day in supreme enjoyment with Krishna and Balaram. One day, a demon took the form of a calf. How devious! How the most innocent creature is a small calf. Their little eyes, their tender limbs, you just want to hold them and do so many things. And this calf came just in such a way that he was completely under Krishna's protection. Yes? Completely under Krishna's protection. But Krishna knew his actual mentality. And he turned to Balaram and said, "You see that calf? That is Batsasura. It's a demon who's come to kill both of us." Balaram, So Krishna walked very quietly. So the little Batsasura didn't even hear him coming. Krishna just very softly came behind him. And then he grabbed his calf's hind legs and started whirling him in above his head with one hand, whirling him in circle after circle and circle, whirling, 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 until Batsasura was so dizzy, it died. Now, Krishna's always thinking of pleasing his cowherd boyfriends. So he saw a kapita tree, and the gopas really like kapita fruits. Does anyone know what kapita fruits are? The gopas like them a lot. So he saw kapita fruit, and all the kapita fruits were very high in the tree. So he especially aimed Batsasura, and he landed right on the top of the tree, and all the kapita fruits fell down, and the demigods showered flowers, and the little boys, gopas, "Well done, well done, well done," and they embraced Krishna, and then they all went and ate kapita fruits. Vatsasura represents the childish mentality in which a devotee is easily influenced by bad association. And in that bad association, we become covered over and greedy for materialistic enjoyment. Now we have read that a devotee should be very simple. In fact, we should be childlike. In Bible, Jesus said, you have to become like a child if you want to enter into the kingdom of God. Innocent, simple, childlike. But at the same time, we must have discrimination. This combination makes a devotee very, very pleasing to Krishna. Otherwise, sometimes, in a childlike way, we put our trust in so many different types of people, even materialistic people. And in that association, very subtly and gradually, we become influenced. Sometimes we find that devotees begin to put their faith in various materialistic people with materialistic processes, to have better relations, to have more feeling of self-confidence, to do whatever you do to your full potential. Now, to learn certain techniques from people, if it can be used in Krishna service, is all right. But we have to be very careful. We have to have a lot of discrimination. Because if we begin to put our faith in people who don't have faith in Krishna, who don't have faith in the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who have an impersonalistic or atheistic conception, or basically a sense-gratificatory conception, that we not only get their techniques, but we also absorb their consciousness. And we become polluted, we become contaminated. And although we're learning something to use it for Krishna's service, pretty soon we're not even using it for Krishna's service anymore. I remember one devotee. He was a nice devotee. Still is, potentially. Nice devotee. Been around for many years. And he went to some group of people who were teaching all these inner development techniques. And he went to seminars and he was paying a lot of money. And he was going around spreading to the other devotees, "I've never been so Krishna conscious. I've never had such good rounds. I've never had such good relationships with the other devotees. Everybody should take this course." And you have to take so many courses, seminar after seminar after. And the people who are teaching, they're pious, but they're very absorbed in sense gratification, and they don't believe in the personality of Godhead. So he was canvassing like anything. It will make you a better devotee, a better Vaishnav. Childlike mentality. After a couple years, I was on the phone with him, and he told me his incredible realization that's transformed his entire life. He said, "I have come to the point in my spiritual evolution where whether Krishna is God or not doesn't matter. Whether there is a God or not doesn't make any difference. That is the level of advancement I have come to." He wasn't talking about Vrindavan Ras. He lost his faith. He lost his faith in his guru. He lost his faith in parampara. He lost his faith in the holy name. He lost his faith in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Because of a childlike mentality. He wanted to put his faith in someone that was not a devotee. And ultimately, he became divorced his wife, found a young girl, and became greedy for materialistic things, and considers that it's a higher platform than the Vaishnavas. This is a real story. Batsasura. Batsasura appears very innocent, very deceptive, very childlike, but in his heart, he simply wants to kill Krishna and Balaram. He wants to kill his faith in Krishna within your heart. So after this happened, it was the gopis. They didn't want to be with Krishna. Gopas was Manasiganga. I think gopis was this. You can make all editorials after. Gopis, I believe, they told Krishna that they didn't want to play with him because he killed a calf. So how do I atone for this? You must bathe in all the holy places. So Krishna came here to Bandiravat, and with the tip of his flute, he pushed it in the ground and created a well. And all the holy places entered into that well. And that well is still here today. Just behind us, it is called Venu Koop. and there's a particular day of the year that the Brijabasis claim if any barren woman drinks the water from that well, she will have babies. Huh? Oh, they have
You're
to
right.
bathe.
They have those two little bathing places on the side.
Sannyasis don't know so much about these. We never took so much interest in that aspect of the well. When Krishna was herding cows, he and gopas would often come to Bhandirvan to play wonderful pastimes. Srimad Bhagavatam describes that in the summer season, which is usually a very, very difficult time of oppressive heat, but in Vrindavan, the summer was just like the spring. So many waterfalls. The waterfalls would make such a beautiful sound that it would cover the cricketing of the crickets. And we're not talking about this type of cricket. We're talking about nice little crickets that sing at night. And the wind. The wind was like a thief. The wind would take the cooling, refreshing waters, the mist of that waters, and carry it to the grass and distribute it. In this way, even in the summer, when there was no rains, every blade of grass was rich green, because the wind would carry the water from the rivers and the waterfalls to the grasses and make beautiful, beautiful, sweet sounds. There was the music of the cuckoos and the bees and the peacocks and the cranes. And Krishna and Balaram would enter into the forest playing upon their flutes. The cowherd boys would decorate themselves with leaves and fruits and flowers and peacock feathers and the rich, colorful minerals of the Vrindavan soils. And the cowherd boys together, they would sometimes dance, and other times they would wrestle, and other times they would sing. Sometimes Krishna would sing, and the cowherd boys would be playing cymbals and horns and flutes to accompany Krishna's singing. And Krishna would be singing, and all the cowherd boys would be playing different instrumentations to accompany him, and they'd all cry out, "Well done, Krishna, well done, well done." And other times, Krishna and Balaram, they would ask the other boys to sing. And cowherd boys would sing and dance, and Krishna and Balaram would be sitting and playing their flutes and buffalo horns and playing different cymbal instruments to accompany their devotees. And they would, Krishna and Balaram would tell gopas, "Very excellent, very excellent, very excellent performance you have given us today." The cowherd boys would whirl in circles together. They would be leaping and jumping and hurling and slapping and pulling each other's hair. Sometimes they would play a game where one cowherd boy would go behind another cowherd boy and cover his eyes with his hands, and he would have to guess who it was. And the cowherd boy wouldn't talk. He would have to understand who it was just by feeling his hands over his eyes. And if he guessed the right way, everyone would just be leaping, "Well done, well done, Harivo!" And if he didn't, everyone would laugh. Ah! So many nice games. Sometimes they would make boats and cross the rivers. They would be playing with the fruits. They would swing from the vines. They would jump like frogs. And they would imitate kings. One day, while they were herding the cows, the most dangerous, deadly of all demons, Pralamba, came into Krishna's association. He, like Vatsasura, did it in a most deceiving, demoniac way. He was very, very carefully looking for an opportunity to kill Krishna and Balaram. What a mentality. And he took note that one particular cowherd boy that would come out with Krishna every day was kept home by his mother that day because he had some duties to perform. Pralambasura disguised himself identical to that innocent, simple little gopa friend of Krishna. And he was just doing all the activities, herding the cows and playing and jumping and throwing balls and jumping like frogs and everything like that, and singing and playing flute and buffalo horn. But Krishna knew within his heart that this is a demon who has come to kill us. But Krishna pretended he didn't know. And he accepted him as a friend. He said, "Oh, I'm so happy you have come today," and he embraced him. And then Krishna was thinking, how to kill this demon. And then he had his plan. He called out to his friends, "Today we are going to play a game where we are going to divide into two different teams. And you can choose, all of you gopas can choose who will be the captains of the teams. And the winner will be carried on the shoulder by the losers." So who do you think the gopas chose to be the two captains of the teams? Sri Krishna Balaram Ki!
Oh, Sri Dhaoji Maharaj Ki!
So they were playing. One game they would sometimes play, it was they would hide. Very nice game. One team would hide from the others. And if anybody from the team found one of the boys, then the boy who was found had to carry the finder on his shoulders and dance around with him for some time and bring him to different places. So they played nice game, and Balaram's team was victorious. Pralambasura took sides with Balaram. No, he took sides with Krishna. So he lost. So Krishna had to carry Sridhama on his shoulders. And Bhadrasena carried Prishab on his shoulders. And Pralambasura chose to carry Balaramji on his shoulders. Now what is explained is, when they were playing this game, Krishna brought them all here to Bandiravan. He actually brought them all to the Mandirabat tree, because this was a good place for them to get on each other's shoulders. Very, very long, nice shade. So it was from Bandiravat, this tree that we are sitting under today, that Krishna brought them, that Pralambasura put Balaramji on his shoulders. And he started to run, and run, and run. And Balaramji was thinking, where is my friend taking me so far away? He's already crossed the border of where we're supposed to go. So Balaramji became very heavy, like Mount Sumeru. And Pralambasura, he was becoming so strained trying to keep Balaram on his shoulders. He was running more and more and more and more, and then he assumed his original form, a gigantic size. His hair was like flames of fire. His eyes were red like coals. He had large, sharp teeth that were practically touching his very demoniac curved eyebrows. He had a long red beard. He looked like a massive cloud. He had golden ornaments, a golden crown, gigantic trident. Hare Krishna. It says that he looked like a gigantic cloud. His ornaments were like lightning, and Balaram on his shoulder was like the full moon. So Balaram was thinking, how is it that my friend has changed in every way? Balaram got angry with him. Not because he was a big, huge demon, because Balaramji wanted to play with his friends. They were right in the middle of games, and this rascal was taking him away from his friends. It was intolerable. He became furious. You are taking me, you are separating me from the playful games of Krishna and the Gopas. One punch, Balaram with his fist on his head. And Pralambasura, this gigantic mountainous demon, his head just split open and he vomited blood and he fell to the ground dead. Sri Baladev ki!
Oh, Sri Dauji Maharaj ki!
And all the gopas cried out, well done, well done! And then they all are so happy. They embraced Balaram as if he had come back from the dead. And the demigods benedicted Balaramji by showering flowers after flowers after flowers. And the gopas were giving benedictions to Balaramji. Pralambasura represents a very dangerous demon that resides within the heart. The inclination to enjoy the opposite sex and the inclination to enjoy profit, adoration, and distinction. This means the inclination for gross and subtle sex. Now, this world, people think this is the goal of life. Yes? Most of the songs, most of the television, most of the movies, most of the books, most of the magazines, most of the products you buy in the market are centered around this enjoyment, Maituna Agar. Such a powerful force. Pralambasura. Very difficult to overcome. And it appears like our friend, like Pralambasura, appeared as Krishna's dear, intimate, lifelong friend. So similarly, these desires appear. The desire for profit, adoration, and distinction, and the desire for other types of physical activities, they promise us happiness, but they cheat us. They kill the inclination for Krishna consciousness within our heart. So we must be very careful. Actually, sometimes I go to California to do some service for Srila Prabhupada's mission. And I meet people from Hollywood, and some producers, some directors, and other people like that. And they're sometimes telling me about movies they're making, spiritual movies. But they say, in order for people to come to see it, we have to put some kind of a sexual scene in it, even if it's not historically correct. They just... I remember when I was a little boy, my parents took me to see the Ten Commandments. And Moses, who's supposed to be a great acharya, he's having an affair. This is not in the Bible. What is this nonsense? But you have to have this. Otherwise, people won't think it's a bona fide movie. Just like a Purana has to have certain ingredients to be bona fide. Hollywood has to have certain ingredients to be bona fide, and this is one of the very main ingredients. Because people have such inclination. the promise of happiness, the promise of pleasure.
But Prahlad Maharaj says it's actually the cause of all pain, this attachment. It steals away our inclination for Krishna consciousness. So that is Pralambasura.
And Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains there's two demons in Vrindavan that Balaram killed. Denukasura and Pralambasura. Denukasura, he represents ignorance of knowledge of the soul through materialistic intelligence. And Pralambasura represents the inclination to enjoy the opposite sex and profit adoration and distinction, gross and subtle. And Thakur Bhaktivinoda explains that these two anartas have to be overcome by the endeavor of the devotee. Under the guidance and instruction of the spiritual master, the devotee must endeavor with all sincerity. It's not just grace. Grace in this sense, the grace of Balaram will come. The grace of Balaram through Guru Tattva will come to exterminate these demons forever, providing we really, really struggle and endeavor to give up the propensity for profit, adoration, distinction, and gross sense gratification. This endeavor, praying to Guru and Krishna, and chanting the holy names, we can become blessed by the causeless mercy of the Lord. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu explains that when you water the seed of devotion, many weeds grow with it. And just like Pralambasura seemed like a trusting, loving friend, similarly, these weeds of profit, adoration, distinction, and gross enjoyment appear to be something very wonderful that may even give us happiness and help us in our spiritual life. And we don't discriminate. And we water the weed, we water the weed, we water the weed until the weed chokes and cripples the devotional creeper. So we must be very enthusiastic to cast away kama esha krodha esha rajoguna samudbhava mahashano mahapapma vidyenam yavairanam. Krishna tells in Gita, it is lust only, Arjuna, which is the all-devouring sinful enemy, which is later transformed into wrath when it is unfulfilled, which is the sinful enemy of the conditioned soul. We must give it up. Therefore, we must, under the Guru's instruction, follow proper regulative principles. And simultaneously, as we're avoiding further contaminating our heart, we clean our heart and access grace by our humility and our chanting the holy names. If we are humble, Balaram in the heart, and the spiritual master will remove these demons. In a few minutes, we'll be going to a place very close by called Bamsivat. You remember we went to Bamsivat in Vrindavan. There is Bandiravam Sivat. Here Krishna would climb that tree and play his flute and call his cows. And also Krishna would call and meet the Braj Gopis here
and perform Ras Leela. Very, very holy, sacred place near the bank of Yamuna. When Krishna was leaving Vrindavan with Akrura, Sridhama, the beloved brother of Sri Radharani, he was in so much distress that Krishna was leaving. He asked Krishna, when are you going to return? And Krishna said, either tomorrow or the day after tomorrow. And Sridhama said, well, I will wait right here until you return. And he waited and waited. One day, 2 day, 3 day, 1 week, 2 week, 3 week, 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, 1 year, 2 month, 2 year, 3 year. He waited and waited and waited. And if you go to Bamsivat, there's a deity of Sridhama who's still waiting. Still waiting for Krishna to return. But when Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu roamed through the 12 forests of Vrindavan, he came to Bhandirvan, and he went to Bamsivat, and there he saw the deity of Sridhama still waiting for him. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu just started running toward him. He said, Sridhama, 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 I have come, I have come, I have returned, here I am. And he embraced Sridhama. Shri Gauranga Mahaprabhu ki! So here at Bhandirvan, a place of unlimited beautiful pastimes under the Bhandirabhat tree, we are assembled. Is it not a beautiful, charming place? It's the place of Sakyaras, Madhuryaras, Vatsalyaras. All the rasas are taking place here at Bhandirvan. Let us offer our prayer, our very sincere and humble prayer, that we can, by our sincere efforts, attract the affection of Srimati Radharani. By pleasing Sri Guru and the Vaishnavas, and sincerely hear and chant the glories and names of the Lord, we can attract the affection of Srimati Radharani. And it is that affection that is the only means by which we can overcome all obstacles. Let us pray for that causeless mercy. Let us beg for that causeless mercy. And when that mercy comes, then the actual taste and realization for these beautiful pastimes will awaken in our heart. And then our eternal occupation will be to spontaneously and ecstatically chant the holy names. We will now hear from His Grace, Dina Bandhu Prabhu.
Om Ajnana Timirandasya Gyananangana Chalakaya Chaksuru Nilitanyena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama Sri Chaitanya Manovistam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Sayam Rupa Gadanayam Aradhanaschanandandai Ramyache Puna Puna Srimadrupa Padambujo Nisyam Janmajanmani Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadara Srivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare Hare
I think Jagatrini already expressed it. Somehow this is one of the most wonderful places in Braj. It just becomes, I don't know, it's just, there's something very special sitting here under this tree, all the devotees. I mean, just imagine, this is practically, you know, we could all just live under this tree. What is the need to go back to Bombay? We'll just live under this tree. It's giving shelter to all of it. Look, the entire congregation here is in shade. Not like they're in Belgaum. We're all in the shade here. Such a wonderful tree. So Maharaj was giving so many wonderful instructions. I was reminded, he was talking about how this sense gratification, it looks like our friend. Material energy is made in such a way that it always looks so enjoyable, but it only gives pain. That Krishna told in Bhagavad Gita, that happiness that feels like pleasure in the beginning turns into pain in the end. So one time, this very, 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 very old story back in the, what was the name of that street where the old Berserkli temple was? Before they had... Telegraph Avenue? No, Telegraph, I thought that's where we chanted. Anyway, there was an old temple before the one we have now. No, that's San Francisco. But anyway, there was an old temple in Berkeley. It was a very nice temple, very nice place. And somehow or other it was somebody's appearance day, so it was a half-day fast. Now, for Westerners, half-day fast? Oh my God, how will we survive? So, anyway, somehow or other we managed to fast for half the day. Then there was the noon artik, you know. Those days we take, you know, some of the temples, we would after lunch, then we would run out on sankirtan. So we'd do all kinds of chores, cleaning the temple, this and that. So anyway, somehow or other we managed to survive half the day. Then there was the noon artik. After the noon artik, we ran to the prasadam hall. We all sat down. The plates were coming out. Even before the prasad came, we were chanting the mantra, you know, Mahaprasad, just wanted to get through that, you know. And this is long, long, long time ago, before chocolate was illegal, you know. So they had cooked chocolate cake with nice, thick chocolate icing on top of it. Everybody was just, you know, waiting to get to the end of that mantra, you know. Looking at that chocolate cake with this thick, creamy chocolate icing on top, you know. As soon as the prayer was over, everyone paid their obeisances, everybody grabbed that chocolate cake, and everybody took a bite, but the neophyte cooks had put salt instead of sugar in the icing. Everyone took a bite. But again, it looked so nice. Such thick, creamy, black chocolate icing. No, but I guess from fasting half day, my taste buds went funny. You know? So again, they took a bite. Some people had to go three times. So that's material enjoyment. It looks nice, but as soon as you bite into it, it's salty. They put tons of salt where there should have been tons of sugar. That's the way material existence is. So he was talking about this Pralambasur, this prophet adoration. This is like the hardest one. Yesterday Maharaj reminded me of this story because he's talking about the elephant, you know. Because old days, when I was a little boy, we used to see in the National Geographic, we'd see India, you know, we'd see this big elephant, you know, picking up huge logs and putting them on the train car, you know. We would see these pictures. You saw those when you were a kid in the National Geographic? I used to see anyway. This is our idea of India, you know, they have these big elephants that pick up trees and put them on the railway cars. But you know what they do? Is they take a little elephant. Because this is a trained elephant, you know, that do this, they have to do the work, so they're trained, they're tamed. How do they tame them? They take a little baby elephant, they take a great big stake, and they pound, 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 pound that stake into the ground, then they tie a big rope or a chain around his foot.
And that little elephant runs around and around and around and pulls and runs around and around and around. Even sometimes his foot is bleeding. After a while, he realizes he can't pull that stake out. So after a little while, then he just, all right. As soon as they put that chain, he just sits peacefully. Even after he's a huge grown elephant, he's lifting logs. What is this little stake? He's lifting logs, putting them on the train. They put that little chain around his foot. Then they don't even make a big one. They just put a little stake, and he just stands there. Because he knows. He gave up trying. He gave up trying. Now he's a huge elephant. He's picking up logs. What is this little stake? But he gave up trying. Somehow, something may inspire him, you know. He sees a sugarcane field somewhere, you know, it's like a Padiyatra elephant. Somehow, just rip it out. So like that, we're chanting, we're following these regulative principles, we're doing all this devotional service. You're growing. You're growing. You may think, no, it's impossible. How will I ever throw this deep, dark stake of material enjoyment out of my heart? But don't stop trying. Don't become the elephant. Just, no, I'm stuck. I'll never get it out. You just go on chanting, praying for the mercy of your spiritual master. One day, some word the spiritual master will say will inspire you. You've been growing in spiritual life. You'll just take that stake of lust and anger and throw it as far away. Don't stop trying. It's like Maharaj said, this is very good, Bhaktivinoda said, this is by the devotee's endeavor. You have to keep trying. You're growing in spiritual life. Don't think, no, it's impossible. Just keep on trying. One day you'll throw that stake of lust far from you. So sitting under this tree, this Bandirva tree, this is such a wonderful place. And Shivaram Swami, he's given such a wonderful rendition of this pastime in his book, Venu Geet. So just to relish it double, I'm going to tell this story again, but relishing the way Shivaram Maharaj has squeezed so much sweetness and nectar out of this pastime. Because now you see, we crossed over the river. You guys had to go all the way around like that. We just went like this. We're on the same side as, remember we crossed the river? I didn't go that day. I tried to go, but something happened and we never made it. But you were in Gokul and Ravel, just nearby. So that time, you know, Krishna was very small, and we heard Malati the other day. Some of you heard Malati the other day telling about, you know, Prabhupada was going off in this car, and and Saraswati was there. Prabhupada, Prabhupada. Suddenly a brahmachari came and said, Prabhupada says Saraswati should come. She was out the door and gone. Yeah. So like that, sometimes Krishna, he just wouldn't be passive. He wouldn't stay home, and Nanda Baba also, he can't live without seeing Krishna. So he would just take Lala on his shoulder and come over this way herding the cows. And Lala is just a little boy, so Nanda Baba would show him, oh Lala, look, see the gilari? See the little chipmunk running up the tree? Just like we saw yesterday. There in Chomua, we saw. See? Oh, Lala, look, there's parrot. Huh? You see the parrot picking at the fruits and dropping little pieces on top of Dita Bandhu, see? Huh? Oh, Lala, look, there's a tamal tree. So Mangi Mataji is sitting right underneath this beautiful tamal tree here. Oh, Lala, look at this big, tall buttvich, banyan tree. Huh? Oh, Lala, look, there's, what do we call this tree? Oh, now I forgot. Slipped my mind. Ye lambe lambe wala?
Papri.
Huh? Papri. Papri. See this big tall tree, papri. And they make these little tiny seeds come in like little paper, you know, and they float all over the place. And the Gurukul boys used to collect them all and tear up in the paper. It's just like, this is Krishna's packaging, you know. So like this, Nanda Baba was showing him, look there, look Lala, there's a Jamuna, look Lala, see this tree, look Lala, there's a mango tree, Lala, look like this, he's showing. And sometimes Lala's asking, oh, Baba, what is this tree, which leaf has got a tail? Ye khaen ki pher, he just ka patte ki poonch, eh, Baba? Ye khaen ki pher, just patte ki poonch. Huh? And Baba would look and say, oh, Lala, this is peepal tree. You saw? Shaped like a little heart and a little poonch tail is there. So in this way, enjoying the beauty of Vrindavan forest, Nanda Baba wandered over here toward this Bandirvan. Suddenly on the horizon, we have seen at the end of the summer, all of a sudden you'll see the whole horizon turns black. And even before the rain comes, you're blazing hot, but all of a sudden this cool breeze starts to blow. Even before the rain comes, you get relief from the summer. So Nanda Baba, he saw this huge rainstorm is coming. Now he's wondering what to do. Because if he takes Lala home, then all the cows, when the thunder and lightning comes, they'll all run here and there, and then he'll have to spend hours and hours trying to get all the cows back together. And if he tries to get all the cows together and take them home, then Lala's going to get wet, he'll get sick, he'll die. The parents are always worried about the children getting sick. From West, you know, when we went to come here and we went to bring the children, you can't imagine what the grandparents, our parents said, oh, no, no, don't take him there to India. He'll get some disease and die. So then the Baba, he can't think what to do. Should I collect the cows? But Lala will get sick. He'll catch a cold. And if I take him home, the cows are, he didn't know what to do. Suddenly, from rubble, Radharani manifested a beautiful form as a Vandevi, beautiful golden forest goddess. And she suddenly appeared before Nanda Maharaj. And Nanda Maharaj saw this beautiful forest goddess. And he said, oh Devi, oh energy of Lord Vishnu, please take this child home and put him in the arms of Mother Yasoda, because rain is coming, he's going to get wet and he'll get sick. Please take him home. And he put that child into the arms of this beautiful golden forest Devi, who held that little child very close to her breast. Like this. And then Nandabhava began collecting all the cows. So Radharani, in this beautiful Kishori form, she wandered over here. As soon as she came underneath this Bandir butt, suddenly that little boy manifested his form as a beautiful 16-year-old Kishore with beautiful lotus petal eyes, beautiful Ganesham, just like lumps and lumps of blue musk, bunches and bunches of blue lotus flowers, and just as soft as butter, and beautiful peacock feather in his hair, so beautiful reddish palms and soles of his feet, so beautiful Kishore Roop. Suddenly Brahma appeared, then all the Gandharvas appeared, Apsaras were dancing, Gandharvas were singing, Kinnaras were playing the instruments. All the Astasakis also appeared in their Kishori forms. Like that. In this way, Brahma performed a beautiful wedding ceremony. Everybody was singing, everyone was dancing. As the Sakis, they tied Krishna and Radha together in a big knot, like this. And everyone was just enjoying like anything. No one wanted to leave, pushed by the yoga maya potency. Lord Brahma fulfilled his desire. He had performed penances and austerities to be able to give Radharani away in marriage. So he had fulfilled his desire somehow or other by the force of yoga maya. He got back on his swan, he left. All the demigods, Gandharvas, Kinnaras, they all left. The Sakis left, even the forest animals left. And Radharani cooked wonderful feast for her Prananath and fed him with her own hand, like that. After eating, then they began to wander through the forest. And in the beautiful forest of Bandirvan, if you had time to wander through this forest, so beautiful forest. And they were playing hide and seek. Radharani would hide behind a tree and then look out, and Krishna would see her, he'd run, but she'd be behind another tree, and Krishna would hide behind a tree, and Radharani with her kanjana. I wish I would have shown you. Sometimes we had these little yellow flowers at Brindakund, this yellow canare. It's like Barha Pitam Natavapu Bhavarapu Karnayo Karnikayam. This karnika, this is this beautiful yellow flower. And karnayo is plural, but Viswanath Chakravarti says, Sometimes he wears in this ear, sometimes he wears in that ear. Not in both at the same time. Sometimes this one, sometimes that one. But this beautiful black bird comes, very, very tiny, very, very bluish black and shiny. And they're very restless. They come here, take a little nectar, and it's over here. Therefore, Radharani is known as Kanjanaksha. Eyes just like the beautiful blackish, bluish eyes. Sometimes our devotees here, Westerners here, Radharani's blue eyes, they paint just like German eyes. It's beautiful blackish eyes like this Kanjana. So Radharani's eyes would just be looking here and there like the Kanjana bird, where is Krishna? Then he would pop out from behind another tree. In this way, they were wandering through the forest. Then they came to a very beautiful place where suddenly the land became just like a dancing platform. And Radha and Krishna began to perform their ras. And their ankle bells and bangles were tinging, just in syncopation with each other. Ting, 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 ting. And the thunder was going on. The thunder was imitating the sounds of their feet as they danced on that platform. Pata, 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 pata. Pata, 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 pata. Like that. Then suddenly, Nanda Nandan, he saw these beautiful forest pigments. And he began to decorate Radharani with so many different colors, like this. And putting colors here and there in places we won't even mention here, like that. And then Radharani, she also took those forest pigments, and when she went to place them on Krishna, suddenly he became a beautiful little child again, crying. And Radharani began to cry, "Oh Prananath, what is this illusion? Why are you putting me late? Oh, where's my Prananath gone?" She began to cry. Then a voice from the sky said, "Hold your patience, Radhe. In the future, all your desires will be satisfied on a future night." So Radharani composed herself. She picked up that beautiful blackish child, held him close to her breast, and she took him to Gokul. And Mother Yasoda, suddenly she saw this golden light entering the door of the house. She ran to the doorway. She saw this beautiful golden forest goddess there. And that forest goddess said, "It's rain was coming, so Nanda Baba entrusted me this little child and told me to put him into the arms of Mother Yasoda. So I'm bringing you this child." And she handed that child to Mother Yasoda. And Mother Yasoda said, "Oh Devi, oh energy of Lord Vishnu, thank you very much." And she also took that child close to her breast. And she took him. He must be tired. She fed him milk from her breast. And then she took him into the room and put him to rest. Meanwhile, Radharani, she again came back into that little baby form in Raval. Meanwhile, the peacocks and all the animals of the forest who'd seen this beautiful dancing of Radha and Krishna, and as soon as the thunder and lightning started sounding, all the peacocks began crying very jubilantly. Ew! 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 And all the birds and animals were making their sounds, and so the thunder and lightning was, and peacocks crying. Ew! So Mother Yasoda, hearing this huge racket, she became very frightened that what's happening to Lala. And she ran into the bedroom and she saw such a beautiful, sweet smile on Lala's mouth. In another part in Raval, Mother Kirtan, she also became frightened hearing all these loud noises. She ran to Radharani's little bedroom and she saw Radharani sleeping so peacefully, with such a beautiful, sweet smile. Both of them were dreaming about their wonderful fantasy marriage underneath this Bandirva tree and sleeping very joyfully and peacefully. Hare Krishna. Jai Jai Sira. Also, you'll see behind that Venu Koop, somehow Krishna's mukut is also there. You see a beautiful mukut of Krishna? On the both sides, you see these little stalls there, because when Somavati Amavasya comes. You know Somavati Amavasya? Som, you know, Sombar. Som means another name for moon. And the first day of the week we call Monday, very interesting. Even in Spanish they call the moon Luna, and the first day of the week is Lunes. That's very interesting. In every culture the names of all the planets are there in the days of the week, in every culture. So Sombar, when it's Monday, and Amavasya, we call it new moon, but actually there's no moon. They're saying new moon day, but there's no moon on that day. Amavasya. So when Monday and Amavasya come together, early in the morning, about four, you have to come all night long. The Brishbazis are singing their beautiful songs. So beautiful songs they sing all night long. Then early in the morning, streams of milk begin to come up in this Benu coop. And then those ladies who've never been able to have child, or the child was stillborn or died shortly after birth, somehow or other, they all come in a brand new sari, which they leave behind. And then they go, there's little stalls there where they can bathe. You see on the side, they crouch down and everybody bathes them for this water. It's practically this, by 6 o'clock in the morning, it's just black. It looks like ink coming out. They've taken so much water out of this well. And big festival is here. Sometimes we come with the Food for Life van and have big kirtan, because nowadays mela means they make some aloo tikkis and they sell, you know, churi, you know, glass bangles, and there's nothing spiritual going on. So I always try to come here whenever somewhat, bring a whole bunch of devotees, have big kirtan, because mela means without the chanting of the holy name, there's no mela. To us, mela means that we must chant very loudly, Hey Krishna! Hey Krishna! Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare, Hare. This is mela for us. So I always try to come and have big kirtan, distribute halava to Angali Jolani Wali Gadam Halava. Burn your finger hot halava to all the Vrishvasis. So we have other places to go, so I'll stop here. Though I'd like to sing some of those nice songs that the Brishbazis sing. Yeah. 2 minutes. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dam. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dam. Jai Jai Shyama, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dam. Jai Jai Shyama, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dam. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dam. Jai Jai Gopi, Jai Jai Gwal, Jai Jai Sada Bihari Lal. Now most of you, you know Gopi and Gwal, but some of our friends here, they don't understand. Gwal, just like the person who drives the rickshaw is the rickshaw wala, The guy who makes the sweets is a sweetwala, who takes care of the goes. He's the gowala, 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 gwal. Jai Jai Gopi, Jai Jai Gwal, Jai Jai Sada Bihari Lai. Jai Jai Gopi, Jai Jai Gwal, Jai Jai Sada Bihari Lai. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Chan, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dai. Pavana Radhe, Tero Naam, Pavana Sri Vrindavan Dai.
Oh Radhe, your name is here. Your Sri Vrindavan Dai is here.
Oh, Pavana Radhe, Tero Naam, Pavana Sri Vrindavan Dai. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Jan, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dai. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Jan, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dai. Govinda Govinda Gauge, Prema Padartha Pauge. Govinda Govinda Gauge, if you will sing Govinda Govinda, Prema Padartha, that Padartha, that thing called Prema, Pauge, you will taste that thing called Prema. Govinda Govinda Gauge, Prema Padartha Pauge. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Jan, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dai. Oh, Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Jan, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dai. Radhe Shyam Bisaroge, Jiti Baji Haroge. Radhe Shyam Bisaroge, Jiti Baji Haroge. If you'll forget Radhe Shyam, Radhe Shyam Bisaroge, Jiti, you know Jit, to win, Jiti Baji Haroge. Instead of winning, you'll lose everything. Radhe Shyam Bisaroge, Jiti Baji Haroge. Radhe Shyam Bisaroge, Jiti Baji Haroge. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dai. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Dai. Bolo Santana Hare Hare, Mukha Pe Murali Adarari. Bolo Santana Hare Hare, Mukha Pe Murali Adarari. Bolo Santana Hare Hare, all you saints sing Hare Hare. Which Hari? Mukape Murali Adar. Adar means lips. Murali Adar Dari. Bolo Santan Hari Hari. Mukape Murali Adar Dari. Bolo Santan Hari Hari. Mukape Murali Adar Dari. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Das. Manasi Ganga, Sri Hari Dev, Giri Bharadari Ki Prakrama Dev. Manasi Ganga, Sri Hari Dev, Giri Bharadari Ki Prakrama Dev. Manasi Ganga, Sri Hari Dev, Giri Bharadari Ki Prakrama Dev. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Das. Kunda me charna mitale, apana jivana safala kare. Kunda me charna mitale, apana jivana safala kare. Kunda me charna mitale, and all the kuns take charna mit. Apana jivan, make your life. Safal, fal, you know, fruit. Safal, fruitful, successful. Kunda kunda me charamitale, apana jivana safala kare. Kunda kunda me charamitale, apana jivana safala kare. Jai 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 Jam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Das. Oh Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Das. Jai Jai Gopi, Jai Jai Gwai, Jai Jai Sada Bihari Rai. Jai Jai Gopi, Jai Jai Gwai, Jai Jai Sada Bihari Rai. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Jam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Das. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Das. Jai Jai Radhe, Jai Jai Shyam, Jai Jai Sri Vrindavan Das. Brajabhumi Vrindavan Dhama Ki Jai. Oh Krishna Kaniya Lala Ki Srimati Radha Rani Ki Jai.